Good evening and welcome to the Rock Bowl, where the 7-0 Duhawks host the 7-0-1 Carleton Knights for some women's soccer action. My name is Ryan Haywood, and I am joined tonight by David Peters. David, welcome to the broadcast.
Oh, it's great to be back here in the booth with you. Tonight we have an exciting matchup between the number 16 Loras Duhawks and Carleton College, who are just outside of the top 25. Loras' defense has been stellar so far this season. Loras coming into the game leading all of D3 in defense, only facing six shots to start the year.
See, and we talk about how great this defense is for Loras College, but let's talk about some statistics on the offensive side. Savannah Johnson, number 7, has 6 goals on the season, 1 assist, 13 points on 32 shots. A incredible season, dare I say.
Oh, yeah. She's the Duhawks leader on offense. You know, up behind her, you have Lindsay Reagan with 2 goals and 6 assists. They're getting each other the ball this year. That's what you want to see offensively from the Duhawks.
And again, another talking point for this Duhawks team is Kendall Kells. Again, she's having a fantastic season as well. She's only faced a handful of shots, David.
Yeah, 6 shots to start the year. Through 7 games, it's under 1 shot a game.
It's incredible to see here. We'll see how this Carleton Knights team responds tonight.
Yeah, coming to this one, Loras has allowed zero goals into the year. And Carleton's only allowing under 1 a game at .75.
The game is now underway here in the Rock Bowl. And this is the second ever matchup between both these squads. The last one coming in 2017, 7 years ago tomorrow.
Yeah, that resulted in a 3-0 Loras victory.
Ball is kicked out on the side, and we'll have a Knights throw-in.
Yeah, this is Loras' toughest matchup so far in the season.
And when we talk about this Knights offense as well, they are led by number 14, Catherine Kreese, with 7 goals, 3 assists, 17 points, and 17 shots on the year so far.
Yeah, this Knight offense, they do a good job spreading the ball around and that everybody get a piece of it.
Certainly a team effort here with Kells with a booming kick near around the 40-yard line. Duhawks trying to establish offensive possession. They'll have to take it off from the sideline.
Yeah, the defense today is going to be the storyline for both sides. So as I mentioned earlier, Loras has not allowed a single goal, while the Knights have only allowed under 1 a game. So this will be a very tough defensive match for both sides.
David, who do we have starting out for the Carleton Knights?
Yeah, for Carleton, at goal, they have Avery Trapp. And then they have Lauren Caldwell, Claire Burberry, Piper Dean, Ashlyn Hay, Dylan Baker, Thea Troll, and Hadley Twitchwell.
The Duhawks still on the offense here. Again, we mentioned Kells in net for the Duhawks. We have number 2, Belle Johnson, also starting. Number 3, Christina Salerno. Number 7, Savannah Johnson. Number 8, Lauren Riggle. Number 20, Sierra Morgano. Number 22, Athena Sheets. Number 27, Kaylin Frost. Number 28, Reagan Lindsay. Number 31, Carly Weiss. And number 33, Izzy Russman, of course, starting here for your Duhawks. Now, an important change this year in the NCAA for soccer, and that is at 15 minutes, there will be a pause in the game for substitutes. Again, that'll be in the first half as well as in the second half. So we'll see what kind of effect that has here in this one with the Knights now on the offense.
Yeah, that allows you to get more rotations in throughout the game.
Certainly so. And a great steal there, looked like from Reagan Lindsay. And, David, it seems like this is going to be a little bit of a feel out for both squads here as we get just started here in the game. How important is it to try and just test your opponent out for the rest of the game?
Yeah, you kind of want to see what their tendencies are and see what works against them, what doesn't. And roughly these first 15 minutes or so will be what your feel-out process.
The Duhawks trying to get the ball back on offense, of course. Good defense there. Try and prolong this drive for the Knights. Throw in towards the end zone here. And the ball will go out of bounds. Great defense for the Duhawks. No saves yet, of course, but plenty of time left for that to change in this one for both squads. Kells with a booming kick once again to the 40. A couple of headers here trying to establish possession. Knights playing good keep away here against the Duhawks, trying to establish some rhythm.
Yeah, this is Loras' fifth home game of the year. They're hoping to keep their perfect record at home, while Carleton's hoping to keep a perfect road record as well, as this is their fifth game on the road.
Yeah, the Knights are 3-0-1 at home. Of course, their one tie coming to Simpson College, who the Duhawks will see on October 19th in Indianola.
Yeah, they're 5-0-1 in non-conference games.
And that is trapped there in net for the Knights. Taking it up midfield. They're going to try and pass it out, and it does go out. Duhawks ball.
Yeah, both sides have done a good job changing possession so far. Nobody's really gotten a major push on the field.
Yeah, and David, kind of just as we suspected here with just a very defensive-heavy game early.
Yeah, both teams shut down the other team's offenses at a high rate this year.
Duhawks now on possession. Some nice dribbling skills there. And the ball is out of bounds once again. Does take a look. Let's take a look. Let's see. Is this a corner kick coming up for the Duhawks? Does look like an official was talking to a Knight player. In the first half, the Duhawks trying to get near the goal. Great defense for Carleton. And kicked right off the face. That was great defense for the Knights. And out of bounds once again.
Yeah, the Duhawks are coming off a 1-0 victory at home versus Carroll University this past Saturday, while Carleton's coming off a 2-0 home victory against Concordia College Moorhead on Saturday. So both teams are coming in off major victories, with Carleton coming on a two-game win streak.
Yeah, and Laura's playing Carroll University on Saturday, and that was a very good game for those of you that didn't see it. That was a 1-0 victory again for the Duhawks. And as we saw in that game, it took a while for the offense to get going, for a lot of shots to start building up.
Yeah, they were tied at 0 heading into halftime. Well, until the second half where Loras struck for the game-winning goal.
There's Trap with the ball, getting set to kick it. And we'll see what the Knights can do on this offensive drive. A little change of possessions very quickly. And Reagan Lindsay for the Duhawks will throw it into Johnson. That was headed out. That was number 33, Izzy Russman there. And the Knights are charging upfield. Nice defense for the Duhawks.
Yeah, this Loras defense flies to the ball.
Ball at midfield. It is kicked to the other side. Duhawks trying to get a shot on goal, and Trap will come out, field the ball. A little bit of a risky move there.
Yeah. Coming out of the net, it's always a little risky just because you leave up so much more room for the offense to get past you.
Duhawks kicking it out, and the Knights will have a throw-in once again. Going toe-to-toe are the Knights with the ball, and it is careened out of play. Just under 34 and a half minutes left in this first half. The Knights kick it midfield. The Duhawks kick it out.
Yeah, Loras wanted to clear the ball to the other side of the field.
Easily so. Athena Sheets is going to kick that one towards the goal, and it is saved by Trap. Not a whole lot of pressure there.
No.
Trap is going to kick a towering ball up to the other 40. Duhawks are going to get possession once again. There's Johnson. Waiting for her teammates, trying to pass it around. And Riggle finds another Duhawk open, now over to Bell Johnson. Johnson's going to kick it just wide of the net.
A little more on target, that could have been in the back of the net.
Trap safely kicking it over to her team. Sam Gotch there for the Knights, going to kick it around, and Duhawk falls. Knights back with it.
It's a nice save on the edge of the field right there.
Looks like a little turnover here for the Duhawks, headed by the Knights. Seemingly looks like that's a nice keep there for the Knights. They will kick it out. The save to keep it from going out of bounds, and it is kicked away by Johnson. Pair of Johnsons here for the Duhawks, getting in on the action.
Yeah, no side is getting any leeway on offense so far.
Knights working up the sideline. Duhawks are going to let it go out. Looks like the ball was last touched by number 14, Catherine Kreese, for the Knights. The throw in here. Headed over to Johnson. It's going to be kicked away before she sees it. and perhaps some rhythm here, stopped by the Knights, playing great defense. Duhawks steal possession, ball goes out of bounds, and here we go again with the Knights with another throw-in. Gotch is going to find Kreese. Kreese is going to kick it back out. And a nice spinning move on that kick there keeps possession here for the Knights as it has worked north, and ball kicked out of play. 31 minutes left in this one.
It's like a whistle was blown before the ball was knocked out of play.
Officials were signaling for Knights possession. Clock still moving here in the Rock Bowl. Dean is going to kick it towards the left side of the net, and it misses very clearly. Kells will kick it out once again. Again, a nice curved shot there. Of course, coming up just short of Kells and the post.
Yeah, the curve's a little more than she wanted it to. If it was a little bit longer of a curve, has a better chance of getting the top corner than that.
Knights at midfield with the ball. Duhawks going to kick it away. Make the Knights run for it. Trap signaling that she's got it. She certainly does, and it rolls back out to Kreese. Kreese is going to keep the ball moving here. The Duhawks are going to steal it away, kick it back. A nice back and forth game here early. Knights throw it in. Kick it out, and a save made by Kells. She lays on it.
A little bit of work here early with these goalies.
There's a little can of corn kicked to about the 50-yard line. And Duhawk possession signaled by the officials.
Yeah, you can see the Knight defender push the back of the Duhawk, trying to get some more separation so she make a play on the ball.
It'll be Salerno here for the Duhawks to kick it in. Approaching 28 and a half minutes in the first half. Salerno is going to kick it mid part of the field. A couple headers missed, and Trap is going to save it from going out.
Turn to a race, see if we get the ball first.
Yeah, a little risky again from Trap here, understandably so, with the defender there. Makes it a little safer for you to save the ball. Nonetheless, the Knights go marching back again. It'll be Lindsay here with the throw-in, surveying where her teammates are at. She'll make a decision. And off the back of the Knights, Lindsay will do it again.
Moves the ball down the field a bit more.
That time, she was targeting Riggle, now Johnson. She's going to kick it over. She's going to try and find Bell Johnson. She does. And that did not look good at all. We'll take a look at the replay here. And Johnson, looks like she trips up a little bit, sticks her foot out, trying to get her bearings perhaps, but nonetheless, Knights with the ball once again.
Yeah, she tried to clear the ball through the two defenders, but her foot got caught in the turf.
Yeah, it's a little bit trickier, David, with the turf, you know, you plant your foot and you don't want to, certainly don't want to injure yourself. And
yeah,
sometimes just forcing your body to make those kinds of plays. Bell Johnson with the throw in for the Duhawks. The ball is carried up. Knights in possession of it, kicked away for Johnson to kick it back. The ball approaching midfield and trap. Out of her net, a couple of great shots here for the Duhawks. They don't get the ball in. And the Knights defense doing a great job keeping the ball in bounds.
Could end it poorly there for the Knights if the defender wasn't right there to rebound the ball.
Trap betting a lot on her defensive skills here early. That's the third time we've seen her go inside the 10.
That's probably the riskiest one right there.
Duhawks trying to get a clear. And they do, ball out of bounds towards their sideline. Knights with the throw in. They've got one shot so far on Kells, looking to make it two here as they charge upfield. And nice block there by the Loras defense. Trapping it out, and Kells will get another kick. Pretty clean game thus far. Two fouls on each side as Kells kicks this one near the 40. Nice job by the Duhawk offense to try and keep it in. And the heading continues. Ball kicked out. And we'll see another throw in. Ball thrown near the 5. Duhawks trying to establish a shot here. They cannot. The Knights keeping it out. Ball kept in here for the Duhawks. And the officials, looks like they're going to give the benefit of the doubt to the Duhawks. Duhawk possession. Salerno with another kick here. Tried to drum up some shot chances for the Duhawks. Headed out by the Knights defense. Savannah Johnson's going to kick it away. And the kick blocked. Once again, the Knights doing a great job on defense.
Both sides do a great job swarming the ball while they're on defense.
Knights at midfield. Gonna kick it back. Try to create some separation here. Perhaps another chance. We'll see. Blocked away by the Duhawks. And it'll be kicked out of bounds. Looked like that was kicked over towards our downfield cameraman. Doing a great job as always. Kells is gonna come out on this one.
I was told the Duhawk defender, stay away. I got it.
Another great kick here for Kells. The ball dribbles down to the 40, quickly kicked away, and back up field. And the Knights not able to save the ball on that one. That was a great opportunity there for Gotch. Here's Lindsay. He's going to throw it in. Getting close and saved there for Trapp. No harm on that one.
That was off the head of a Knight defender. Saved it from being a Duhawk ball once again.
Trapp with another great kick here near the 50. Duhawk's doing a great job of capitalizing on defense. And they do it again, kicking it away to Trapp.
Showing why they've only faced 6 shots on goal all year.
Again, talking about this Duhawk offense, 16 goals in 7 games. That is 5th best in ARC play off of 161 shots, averaging about 23 per game. And, David, that's the most in the ARC. Just north of 20 minutes left in the first half. Duhawks looking for some more shots. And we got a whistle there against the Knights. Ball at midfield, and the Knights are going to take over. Nice slide keep there for the Knights. Ball kicked out of bounds once again. Ball kicked in for the Duhawks. They have an opportunity and saved by Trapp once again.
Yeah, the 4th time she's come out of the net to make a save.
Trapp doing a good job of trapping the ball when she needs to. And the sun's peaking here in Dubuque. It's starting to set a little bit. We got the lights on. Perhaps could be a factor in the next few minutes. We'll see. But for now, the Knights have the ball. Ball upfield for Caldwell. She's dancing and moving. Gets a kick through, and the Duhawks snuff it out. Another kick towards Kells. She goes down to save it. No real trouble there. It looked like it was off the head of a Duhawk defender.
Yeah, but the trajectory changed to the ball as it was kicked.
Take a look at the replay here. And just narrowly off, David.
Yeah, you can see right there. Just skim the top of her head.
And a lot of the times, those are the goals that you don't expect,
mm-hmm.
right? The moment that you least expect it, when the ball kind of takes a weird redirection.
So you're watching the ball the entire way. Then at the last second, it changes where it's going to go.
Duhawks keep it in. The Knights say, nope, we're going to kick it out. Headed back by the Duhawks. Dean will pass it out. Traw over to Gotch. Gotch back to Traw. Playing a little tic-tac-toe over here. And they established possession pretty well near midfield. A couple of Duhawks here to change possession. Here's Johnson. Nice block out for the Duhawks. Another block here for the Knights. The ball slowly rolls out of play. like the official is saying something over to Lauren Riggle. But in any case, the Duhawks with the ball, and it's going to change quickly over to Knight's possession.
Took an awkward bounce, it looked like.
Duhawks converging, and the ball is kept in possession for the Knights. Here we go with their first breakaway opportunity. Saved by Kells, and she swallows it.
Nice diving save right there.
We'll get a closer look on that. Carly Weiss doing her best on defense. And we'll get another stoppage in play here for Duhawk offense. Approaching the 15-minute mark here. Salerno's going to kick it in. Headed out by the Knights. Duhawks trying to keep it in. And a foul here against the Duhawks. Trapp is going to kick it into Knight's offensive zone. Nice ball handling there as there was a trip against one of the Duhawk ladies. And now we've got one. We got a call here against Kaylin Frost. And take a look here, David. And
they tried me to play on the ball. But ended up clipping the foot of a Knight.
Yeah, that was Ashlyn Hay there, David. She's able to get up. She's good. Hadley Twitchell with the kick.
Congregation at the 15-yard line.
Kell's making a good save and getting ready to kick it out. There's a Duhawk down near the 50-yard line. Little run in, and she is good. Always good to see. Salerno kicking it in. He's going to find Duhawk here. Kept in, great defense for the Knights. We'll see Trapp again with another kick out. Again, the Knights doing a great job on defense when it matters the most here.
And I'm making sure that Loras offense can't get anything going towards the goal. Kind of a bend, don't break defense. As soon as the ball gets within the 15-yard line, it just starts swarming you.
The officials point towards their right, meaning Duhawk possession from the sideline. We'll see Bell Johnson. It's perhaps another throw-in. Approaching 11 and a half minutes left in this first half. Quality defense coming in to this game for both squads, and so far doing a great job once again. And this is a sport of momentum, right? So once the momentum is on your side, you kind of ride it. So far, hard to have any of that happen, of course, with great defense. The throw in here. No good. Ball comes back, kicked back out. Riggle tried to keep it in as best she could to no avail, and we'll see another trap kick.
Yeah, couldn't get the angle on the ball to keep it within play.
Lindsay with the throw in here. That was intended for Sheets, but was kicked out by, headed out, excuse me, by the Knights. Now we're going to start seeing some substitutions for both teams.
This is where the urgency is going to pick up. Under 10 minutes left in the first half, you're going to see a lot more shots on goal and a lot more setups.
Sheets comes out for Sesniak with the throw there for the Duhawks.
Sesniak had the game-winning goal last week, or last Saturday.
Duhawks knocking for a goal here. Sesniak's going to throw it in. And the Knights are going to keep it out for now. Trap with the save from Emerson Gasman. Nice diving play there.
That diving header right there.
Yeah, that was Reagan Lindsay there. Knights not able to get that one. Very good back and forth game continuing. Sierra Morgano with the kick. And the Knights will keep it in for now. A little back and forth, and it leads to Knights' possession. Dean with the kick here. Not drumming anything up there.
And neither side is really gaining an edge so far, offensively.
Very much a stalemate, both sides of the ball. A little tie up there on the 40. The Duhawks prevail there. Riggle is going to kick it in and saved by Trapp once again. Foot race here, and Riggle is tripped up there. Play continues. Gotch on Riggle, and the shot just to the side of the net for Riggle. Great defense for Sam Gotch.
Yeah, great job for Riggle to stay afloat after getting tangled up with the Knight defender. Yeah, just off side of the net.
It's the first quality shot that was actually pretty close there. Mm-hmm. I mean, a matter of a couple of feet there. Perhaps the Duhawks are trying to put the pieces together for a goal. We'll see. 6 minutes left on the clock as the ball goes out. Looks like we will see a corner kick here for Reagan Lindsay. As we welcome you into our booth here, Ryan Haywood alongside David Peters. And David, three shots so far for both teams.
Yeah, it's been a heavily defensive-heavy contest. We saw that coming in throughout the season for both sides, and just lived up to that standing so far here.
Kicked away by the Knights. It's number 20, Dylan Baker. But the Duhawks trying to get something going here. Tripped up at the 40. Take a look, see who that is. That's number 17 for the Duhawks, Bella Sesniak.
Looks like it will stay Duhawk ball, though.
Take a look here. Just tripped towards the end of that replay right there. Trap comes out once again. See another kick. And I bet Kendall Kells is thanking her defense so far. Not seeing many shots, comparatively speaking, with Trap. Although the Knights are doing great on defense as well.
Yeah, both sides are doing great on defense, but Loras has snuck by a few shots on the goal.
Perhaps a little edge there, and the Knights kick it just out. The officials signal whistle in. Ball is in. Sesniak just missed the header there. That's Ellie Vahovsky there for the Duhawks. Looks like she is being changed out. She is subbed out here. For number 12, Shiara DeVito. So a couple of substitutions here for the Duhawks to maintain momentum. Ball intercepted by the Knights. Kicked out once again to the 50. Baker in a tie-in, and the ball kicked away towards the Duhawks. Sesniak, the throw-in. She was looking for Stubendick there. Kicked away, and the shot on goal saved by Trapp. Kaylin Frost with a great opportunity there, but relatively harmless save for Trap as we continue play, approaching 2 minutes left in the first half. Bell Johnson with the throw-in. And a penalty once again.
Yeah, both teams have a pair of shots on the goal today. So they're trying their, offensively, but both defenses are standing tall.
Yeah, if you're a defensive-minded soccer fan, you're loving this right now. We'll see what adjustments are made.
1 minute remaining.
With a minute approaching here, perhaps a little sense of urgency for the Knights. They kick it away, but now Duhok possession. Sesniak wanting to throw it in. Kicked out, and she'll try it again. With a header over the net. Just crossing over the top corner left side of the goal. 15 seconds left.
It's a little too high.
Great opportunity there. With the seconds ticking down. And the horn means the end of the first half. 0-0, our score here. And David, let's run through some of the stats here. 3-4. Loras with 4 there. 2 shots on goal, as you had mentioned previously. 2 corners for Loras. So a little bit of a offensive edge into their game.
Yeah, this is, if we go into half, you're looking to see what can we capitalize on in the second. What do we do wrong offensively? What can change?
1 offside call there. 7 fouls for Carleton. They're certainly looking to change that in the second half. 14 minutes goes up on the board for halftime. We will take a break and join you back here in 14 minutes. We are back here in the Rock Bowl for what should be an exciting second half of soccer. Again, if you are just joining us tonight, as the sun starting to set here in Dubuque, you have just caught a great defensive first half. Again, I'm Ryan Haywood. He's David Peters in the booth for this one, and a very exciting defensive match at that.
Yeah, we knew what we were expecting coming into this game. Both teams have allowed very limited goals, especially Loras. They haven't allowed a single goal at all this year, so we knew what we were going to see from this team.
Again, joining us here is our wonderful crew, doing such a great job as always. And let's run through some of the stats here. Again, 4 shots for Loras to Carleton's 3. 2 shots on goal apiece, but 2 corners for Loras, of course, both occurring on the right side of the field. They will switch sides here. Put another 45 up. Both sides getting ready, having some discussions perhaps. Yeah, finalizing offensive game plans and defensive game plans.
Yeah, this is a familiar spot for Loras. Most of their games have seen them go into half tied at 0.
Again, Loras, the preseason number 1 rank in the ARC, and doing a great job holding their title here as we are underway in the second half. Duhok's trying to establish some sort of offensive game. And Lindsay will throw it in once again. Again, this is a women's soccer program that has not lost a home game dating back to April 13th of 2020. And a great save there for Trapp. It looked like the ball jumped off of the top
crossbar.
Mm-hmm.
No, that not losing the home game stat, you know, since 2020 is even more impressive when you factor in they hosted the ARC tournament last year.
Yeah, and David, you and I were on that call, and that went to a very long few rounds of the penalty kick. Of course, with Libby Perry netting that one, solidifying their ARC championship.
That was an exciting game to call.
Very fun. So has this one so far. We are at 43-16 left in this second half. Baker going up midfield with a nice crossover as she is stopped by a pair of Duhawks, and Baker tripping up number 8, Lauren Riggle. Take a look at it here. Riggle and Salerno doing a good job containing Baker with the ball being kicked out and Salerno kicking it back in.
Yeah, he's got tied up and got tripped up a little bit.
Ball headed out. Trapped with another opportunity to get her offense going. The Knights are trying to continue what has proven to be a very successful last couple of seasons. In fact, last year they were first in the MIAC. Of course, that is the Minnesota Intercollegiate Athletic Conference. And had a 9-0-2 record, as that one is in for the Duhawks! Goal for the Duhawks there on the board with their first one of the night. And a nice job there for Johnson to keep the ball in.
Yeah, just snuck right through the arms of the goalie.
Again, the Duhawks leading here. Still plenty of time left for the Knights. But the Loras faithful here, very excited to see a goal up for their team. Bell Johnson here with the throw-in.
That's momentum changer right there.
It is, and we talked about it in the first half, right? And the Duhawks still on the offensive charge here as it is kicked away for the Knights. But definitely something, if you're Coach Matt Pucci, to hang your hat on so far. Again, the Duhawks trying to hold on for what would be their 7th straight shutout. Excuse me, this would be their 8th, and it would break the record for longest shutout streak in program history.
It'll also be the best start in program history.
It would be. Certainly would. Again, a very talented program here at Loras doing their part. Nice move there for the Knights. Kicked away. That was Claire Burberry. Good defense for the Duhawks. K- Tells drops back, charges forward for another booming kick. Baker keeping the ball in for the Knights, kicked away by Salerno.
The Duelks defense not missing a beat after that first half.
Duhawks kicking the ball away. And it looks like Knights will try to keep it in. And a great move to keep it in by Sam Gotch. Forwarded ahead to Burberry and intercepted by the Duhawk defense. Ball will zip by, going out of bounds. Not enough there for Emerson Gassman to keep it in. Thirty-seven minutes left on the clock for the Duhawks. Reagan Lindsay looking to throw it in after this substitution. Bell Johnson going out for Mary Claire Bean. A couple of good headers. Keep the ball out of their zone, and the Knights looking to play some good defense here. Missed header there for the Knights. The Knights are going to quickly regroup on possession. And David, this is a Carleton team with 6 goals allowed, tied second in the MIAC, and only 7 shots allowed per game. Trying to limit these chances by the Duhawks.
Yeah, there's 7 games. They've allowed less than 1 goal per game prior to coming to this one today.
We'll see yet again another corner for the Duhawks. It's Reagan Lindsay at the top of your screen. She's going to kick it in. And saved by Trapp off a great deflection header.
Trapp almost lost that one. She had to regain that ball as it was in the air.
And as we talked about in the first half, deflections doing numbers here for both squads. And again, an easy save there for Trapp once you realize where the ball was at.
Mm-hmm.
Lindsay with another throw-in. Headed out by Baker, and she'll do it again. D Duhawks keeping possession in. Their sideline very happy. Their fans very happy. We'll get another throw in. Thrown intended for Savannah Johnson. It is sent out once again. Knights doing good on defense. Throw in here. Johnson with the header. Saved by Trapp.
Yeah, Loras already has four shots in this second half, matching their total in the first half already.
And we'll take a look at the previous play here. Again, coming close. Looked like there was a Duhawk in front to perhaps screen the chance, to no avail. The officials are going to come together and talk here. There's a stoppage in play. 32:55 left in this one. The clock has stopped. And they're going to say Duhawk possession.
Yeah, they had more time on the clock, too.
Looked like they added about a minute, just shy of a minute, rather, onto the clock. Now approaching 33 minutes left in the game. And the shot is up, and if we were playing football, it would be good, but we are playing soccer here. Again, a good quality chance for the Duhawks. Let's take a look at this opportunity here. Mary Claire Bean with the opportunity.
He's got underneath it a little too much.
Currently, Kendall Kells is the career record holder for shutouts with 36, aiming to make it 37 tonight, and that would be 10 better than the second place holder.
Yeah, shutout today would give Loras their longest shutout streak in program history.
Tomorrow, the poll rankings will be updated. Again, as we mentioned earlier in the call, Loras at 16. Certainly looking like they'll move up the board. Of course, number one in D3, Washington University. Second, Amherst College. And three, Misericordia University. Very impressive programs, for sure.
Yeah, Loras currently is in first place in their region. That includes some schools they will face on later this year and Carleton College.
And you talk about this Carleton team. They've got their coaching staff boasting a combined 42 years of head coaching experience between head coach Mueller and her assistants. Again, very impressive, so they know exactly what they're doing. Again, no panic for them quite yet, although they're looking to get something going here as we approach 30 minutes left in the half. Trying to bring it up the north side here, kicked away. Loras will come away with the ball. Excuse me, Carleton will. The Knights moving up, and the Duhawks making sure they don't. Kicked away by the Duhawks. Again, this is Mueller's fifth season at the helm of this program with a 43-11-9 record. Very impressive indeed.
Oh, yeah. This is a coach that has started building up a program. And, it's, you know, they made the national tournament last year, although they lost in the first round. But that's very impressive for a head coach in her fifth year.
And again, it was her first tournament appearance since 2010. We'll have a changing of the guard here on possession. And Lindsay, once again, looks like she'll be throwing the ball in. Another throw in here for the Duhawks. Couple of quick headers, and Trapp says, I got it. We'll take a look at Zariah Jordan throwing the ball in here, intercepted by the Duhawk defense. Here's Jordan again to Dean. Dean's going to work it out of bounds.
Yeah, Loras averages 23 shots per game, and they're at about 10 shots right now with about halfway through the second half.
Doing a great job offensively. Definitely some adjustments made. And it seemed like at the first end of the first half, a little bit more of a shift. The wins in favor of Loras thus far still ringing true. Here's another throw in. The Knights are going to let it go out of bounds once again.
As we alluded to earlier in the broadcast, that first 20 to 30 minutes of the game is a lot of feeling out and trying to figure out what works well against this defense.
And it seems like that this is a very interesting style of defense for the Duhawks. And really comparable to kickball. They're really trying to just kick the ball out, try and clear it, put some pressure on the other team. And we've seen that time and time again this season.
Yeah, they usually have three defenders on the other side of the field, and once they clear the ball, it's a race to see who gets in that first.
The throw in here. Good enough for the Duhawks. They'll keep it in their offensive zone. Trapp charges for the ball and keeps it. Savannah Johnson. It's going to be a race. Does the ball get there? And It looks like it is saved by the Knights. My goodness, what great defense.
That was close to crossing the line if it didn't.
Holy Toledo. Got some great defense here.
That's the risk you take when you come out of the net as a goalie.
Now let's take a look at that replay here. And Johnson seemingly has a goal here, but Jordan.
By millimeters.
Yeah, misses. I mean, that was Zariah Jordan and Piper Dean on defense there. And we'll get our first corner for the Knights of the day.
That's a tough play for, you know, official to, you know, judge. Great defense by the Knights right there.
Approaching 24 minutes left in the half. We're going to see a change here. Looks like that is number 26, Claire Burberry, going out of the game for Carleton. Here's Gotch with the kick from the corner. The ball's going to go out of bounds. Kells kicks it to about the 50, and the Duhawks are on the run here, a foot race, and Jordan will keep it. Kicked out of bounds, that ball intended for Twitchell. There's Reagan Lindsay looking to throw the ball in. She has done all night tonight. Trying to find Savannah Johnson. Does not go to her. Although she does kick it out of bounds. Duhawks trying to get something going here on offense. The throw in kicked away by the Knights. And right there, a little frustration perhaps from Lindsay as she kicks it away. So let's preview the upcoming schedule here, the next couple of weeks for both squads. For Carleton, they will be at home this Saturday versus Bethel University. And a week later, actually a few days later, October 1st, they will be on the road. Excuse me, they'll be at home at St. Olaf College. And then October 5th against St. Scholastic at home.
Then for the Duhawks, this Saturday they'll be away at Buena Vista. October 1st, they'll be at UW-Whitewater. And then October 5th for homecoming, they'll be welcoming Nebraska Wesleyan to the Rock Bowl.
Getting back to the game here. I have a foul here on one of the Knights. Let's take a look at that. Perhaps a little bit of a
shoulder check, want to call that, or not quite.
A little chippiness, perhaps. Late stage of the game. So the Duhawks establish possession. Ball kicked out and kicked over the net. And the Duhawks will go back on defense. little back-and-forth game here for both squads. And the Knights will kick it away and throw back in for their possession. So, David, if you're Carleton, who are you looking for to step up, perhaps try to find some offensive life for the Knights?
You're looking at Catherine Kress. She's their leading goal scorer and leads their offense. She has 17 points on the season and 17 shots. Although she's second in shots, she does have more land than their shot leader.
We'll see if that happens as the ball kicked out of bounds. Jordan's going to throw in for Dean here. Savannah Johnson kicks it away. They'll try that again. Jordan back to Dean. Kicked back to the goalkeeper. Savannah Johnson applying some pressure there. It's the Duhawks have possession once again. Just approaching 18 and a half minutes left here in the second half.
Still enough time for Carleton to tie this one up.
But again, Loras taking over in this one. 12 shots to the Knights 3. And 7 shots on goal for the Duhawks to the Knights 2.
Yeah, putting a lot of pressure on Carleton to get the ball across midfield.
Trapp going to kick it out. The Duhawks trying to keep the pressure up. And kicked away. We'll see Knights possession. That ball headed away by Twitchell. And Lindsay with the throw in. Here come the Knights. They're going to kick it away. Do a little back and forth here. And we have a foul against Anna Borkowski of Carleton. Kick over, saved by Trapp. Looked like she was going to kick that one away. There were two Duhawk defenders near her. She couldn't do it exactly how she wanted as the ball goes out of bounds.
Yeah, this Loras offense, they have 74 shots on goal this year, and it's most in the ARC, averaging just over 10.5 shots on goal per game.
They're doing an impressive job thus far. And we'll see Allie Stubendick come in for Loras. Salerno kicking the ball out. Stubendick rushing to get it. She's got possession of the ball. Perhaps trying to set something up, but that is quickly snuffed away, and it looks like that's a handball on Loras. Kind of a fortunate bounce there as well. Kind of catches the arm going away. You're not suspecting the ball to come up that way, but regardless, Duhawks trying to get possession once again.
Yeah, Loras has 76 fouls this year, tied for the most in the ARC and sixth most in all of Division III.
Again, fouls in this one, 10-5 in favor of the Duhawks. But for the most part, relatively clean game. Not as many stoppages in time thus far, as the Duhawks charge up midfield. The kick is just to the side, as we have seen a couple of times tonight for the Duhawks. Trapp will have another opportunity to clear.
Yeah, Loras has doubled their shots in the second half with 8 in the second and 4 in the first.
Good opportunity there.
Supplies more pressure, keeps the goalkeeper on their feet.
Jordan's going to find Dean once again. Dean to Trapp, and Trapp to clear it out. Nice redirection for the Knights to keep it in. Again, they haven't had a whole lot of opportunities quite yet. They're looking to rectify that now. Here come the Knights. Two defenders on. Good defense there from Reagan Lindsay. This ball is out of the bound. So here we go, another throw in for the Knights. 13:15 left in this game. We'll get another foul here against the Knights. That was Twitchell with it. Taking down Lauren Riggle. We'll take a look at that here. Just a little trip there.
It's usually what happens on those fights for the ball. You know, just clip somebody's foot.
Hard-fought battle for sure. Trapp fields this one, brings it back in front of the end zone. We'll have a pair of substitutions for the Duhawks coming onto the field. Athena Sheets coming out. Allie Stubendick going out as well. Johnson back in the game here. She's fielding the ball right now. She's going to give a kick, saved by Trapp.
Oh, the ball just floated in the air.
It did. At this point of the game, clock management starting to become a bigger presence, bigger factor here for the Knights. Let's take a look at the last shot here by Savannah Johnson. Good arc on that one, but easy enough for Trapp to track down. Another throw in for the Duhawks. See some fans keeping track of time here. And that one is sailed off the track. Trapp here, another opportunity to kick it away.
That was all the end of the first half. Both teams are upping their intensity as we reach the last 10 minutes of this game.
Ball fielded by the Knights. Couple of Duhawks there on defense to keep them in check. And we'll see Knights possession on the far sideline. And again, taking a look at the ARC conference, Loras 7-0 thus far, yet to see a conference opponent. That'll change in a few weeks, of course. Simpson 5-0-3, good enough for second place. Central 7-2, BV 5-2-1. University of Dubuque 3-1-3, Nebraska Wesleyan 4-5. Wartburg 3-4-1, Coe 3-5-1, and Luther seeking their first win of the season as they are winless 0-5-3. Plenty of season left. Kick booming up now, back to play. And we will see a foul go against the Knights once again. It's number 14, Catherine Kreese there. We'll take a look at the replay here.
A little bit of a missed head.
Yeah, missed header there for the Dewhawks, but fortunate call for them. Salerno going to kick it in. Gets by a couple of Knights, and Trapp will field it. Little tie up north of the 40-yard line, and we'll see Knights throwing it in.
Morris did a great job keeping the Knights off attack in the second half. Had a hard time getting the ball across midfield.
Yeah, containing ball possession in their zone, David, as you're talking right now. Very impressive in the late stages of this one. A little bit of frustration here for movement by the Knights. 8:37 left on the clock. And the Dewhawks kicking it away. Could sense the frustration building perhaps a little bit for the Knights. Again, they're very aware of what they have to do. A nice move there. Keep ball possession. And the kick is saved by Kells. And again, she's only faced three shots in this entire game.
All three came in the first half. No shots for Carleton here in the second.
And here we go, an opportunity here on defense for the Knights. They get a good stop, and they will kick it back to Trapp. This one kicked away and out of bounds. Sesnick going to throw it in here to the far left corner and out. This will set us up for Lindsay's corner kick for the Dewhawks. We've just eclipsed the 7-minute mark in the second half. Here's the kick. It is up off a Loras player and out of bounds.
Yeah, Loras leads all of the Division III in corner kicks with 10 per game.
And they'll add on to that here. Lindsay will travel north for this one. In motion, getting ready to kick. Headed away by the Knights defense. Loras trying to keep pressure up. Kicked back into their offensive zone. Salerno going to catch the ball here. Wait for it to go out of bounds. And it'll be Dewhawk ball.
Did a great job of keeping the defender away from making any contact to keep that ball in play.
And they've done a good job of that tonight. See if they can continue to do that to close out this one. Ball deflects off of Zariah Jordan. It'll be Duhawk ball once again. Sesnick going to throw it in. Just behind Savannah Johnson, she kicks it off of Piper Dean. It looks like Savannah Johnson will be taking the corner kick. 5 minutes left in this one. Knights trying to hurry up here on defense.
Yeah, Laura's doing a great job of taking as much time off the clock as they can.
Doing a great job of it here, kicked away by Johnson. And right now, if you're the Duhawks, all you got to do is just kill a couple minutes.
Mm-hmm. Keep the ball on this side of the field. Don't. Look at all they're doing over there in the corner. Just playing keep away.
Johnson with the throw-in once again, strategically keeping the ball here. Knights finally get possession of the ball. And Loras trying to keep it back in their corner. The Knights kicking it away. Dean with a nice move to keep the ball alive for the Knights. It looks like we'll get a foul call here on the Duhawks. Let's take a look to see what happened here. And it looks like that was Piper Dean who perhaps initiated it, but regardless.
Yeah, if you're the Knights
kick.
If you're the Knights, you don't want fouls to be called at all because you lose so much time to be able to have possession of the ball.
The kick is up and away. Kels doesn't have to worry about that. She can take her time here. The Duhawks staring down their eighth straight shutout. See if they can hold on here. Approaching 2.5 minutes left. Duhawks kicking the ball out of play. Knights trying to hurry it up. Try and get a couple of quick plays in and get this one tied. Ball up in the air. Dean comes up with it. She's going to pass it away. Ball kicked away and near Loras' sideline. Out of play. Still Knights possession. Great pressure here by the Duhawks. Jordan's going to kick it over to the sideline, intercepted by Sesniak, and it goes out of bounds.
One of the last two chances the Knights had to tie this one up.
Ball kept along the north sideline. Baker is going to get there. She's got the ball kicked in between the legs there of Sierra Morgano.
And lucky roll down the sideline just for the ball to stay in.
Yeah, very close here. Approaching 1:10 left with the corner kick for the Knights. Perhaps their biggest opportunity and their most crucial. Here's Twitchell with the kick, and it is headed out. Jordan with the ball. She's going to kick it in. And it was whiffed away by the Duhawk defense, but goes just out of bounds.
That was their biggest opportunity yet.
Arguably their biggest. Keeps this one to a 1-0 lead for the Duhawks. Headed away. And Savannah Johnson's going to kick it away, taking off quite a few seconds for the Knights. Trapp's going to kick it out towards midfield.
By the last possession here for the Knights.
And taken down are the Knights. 8 seconds left on the clock. The Knights trying to hurry it up. And the clock is stopped here with 4 seconds to go.
Big ball is in play for them.
There's Twitchell getting ready to wind up in front of that line. And Trapp is coming along to the other side. Getting in on the action. This is an all-out effort here to try and tie it. The kick is up for Twitchell and saved by Kells. And the Duhawks continue their shutout streak, and it's extended to 8 games with a 1-0 victory at home here in the Rock Bowl against Carleton.
Yeah, back-to-back 1-0 win to the Duhawks.
And we'll take a look at the final play here. And Kells with the all-important save. So again, our final 1-0 Duhawks. And David, let's run through some final stats here. 14 shots for Loras, seemingly taking over in the second half, and Carleton with 4.
Yeah, 10 shots for the Duhawks only in the second half, which is very impressive. A big up in pace from the first half.
And again, the lone goal here by Savannah Johnson at 48-25. In the lower right side. And that'll be it for tonight from the Rock Bowl. Our final 1-0 Loras. For David Peters, I'm Ryan Haywood. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.